select all answer choices that correctly answer the questions. Be sure to consider whether or not each answer choice is correct. You can use tools to help you when you're testing. The OTT will give you helpful hints to practice using these tools. Above each test question, you will find tools such as highlighter, sticky note, magnifier, and line guide. There are other tools as well. You can explore these tools using the OTT. Skipping and reviewing questions. On test day, you can skip questions and come back to them later. You will have a chance to review your work before you are done. To skip a question, click the next arrow and move to the next question. You can also put a flag on a question so you know to come back to it later. To put a flag on the question, hit the flag button. Pause and resume. If you need to go away from your computer, select the pause button. When you come back, hit the resume button. If you are away from your computer more than 20 minutes, you will need to log back in. Your teacher will give you a hard time for that. On test day, it is important that you answer all of the questions and that you review your work. When you have answered all of your questions, click the review/end test button at the bottom of the screen. The review page will show you if you have answered all of the questions. You can then go back to any question you did not answer or go back to any question you flagged. When you have finished and have checked your work, click end test button. When you are sure you are ready, click submit. This screen shows an image to check whether your computer screen is set up correctly. You should see three shaded circles. Please raise your hand if you don't. Okay, and then we're going to hit begin the test. This is what the test looks like. What is the value of the expression 4 plus 6 divided by 2 times 3? So that would be 3 times 3 is 9 plus 4 is 13. We would click B. That's all we have to do. If we thought there was a problem, just hit the flag button. That would show it to us later. If we decided we wanted to highlight something, we could use the highlighter and we could highlight whatever we wanted. Okay? We decided we needed a sticky note. We can take a sticky note, put it down here, and type in what we need. Okay? And a line guide is actually something that you can... It helps you light up as you go down through. Magnifying glass, if you need to make your questions bigger, you can do that. Make sense? Here's options button. You can change the color if you want. If you like blue, green, purple, red, pink, whatever, you can do that.
Why do we need that?
You might if you want to take notes. Instead of using scratch paper. Okay. So notice we've done a lot of these questions. Practice hint number one, use the sticky note tool to make notes on calculations before you answer. I'm going to give you scrap paper too, so you can do it that way. Difference in the weights in pounds between the heaviest hamburger and the lightest hamburger. Well, 2/4, 5/8. Looks like 3/8 maybe. Okay. Use the magnifier. Gosh, another one of these. Select all shapes that Sasha could use. This is more than one answer, more than four answers. Sasha is designing a window. Sasha wants to choose a shape that is a quadrilateral for her window. So quadrilateral would be any...
I think we're going triangle window.
Four sides, right?
That's one heck of a weird window, see?
Yep. Enough questions are very similar to what we've been doing. There's Sergi riding his bike again. This is what will happen before we submit. You'll notice that we have two unanswered questions. It's going to prompt us to go back to the to it. Okay? So we'd hit the return to questions. It would come back. Sergi rode his bike for 1 hour, 1.25 hours. For how many minutes did Sergi ride his bike? He rode it for 75 minutes. 60 plus 15. If we hit next, it'll take us, okay, so we'd back again, return to the question unanswered. See what the other one was. There it is. What is the distance in kilometers from Carrie's home to his cousin's home? 20 kilometers. Two. So we're going to do that. Okay.
How do you get back to the 5 questions?
We're here. All you have to do is go back. That's all you have to do. Okay? You can hit and click on the question. That's all you got to do. So if you decided you wanted to take a look at question number 3, and you are on this page, you can just go to question number 3, click on it, and it takes you right to it. Make sense? I need help, right here's my help button. Open help, and it gives me all the directions and everything else I need, how to navigate, tools, and stuff like that. Make sense? Okay, when we're done, we hit end test. It's going to say, you have answered all the questions. To check or change your answers, select return to review. Okay, and then we can go back and take a look at the questions. Okay, or we can just go to end test. Hopefully you go back and end your test the right way. To restart the online tools training, click here, test below. Okay, I think I can probably put this on Google Classroom for you.
Isn't this like the same every year?
Yeah. I will put that